Alcoholics quick cap here. They know the story of the founding of Alcoholics Anonymous has been told over and over, and it's been the subject of dozens of books, and they even made a full-length film about it. A good film called My Name is Bill W., with an all-star cast, James Woods, James Garner, Gary Sinise, and Joe Beth Williams. Now the story, of course, is about a kind of a broken-down stock hustler from New York, Bill Wilson, and he was in real trouble. Now, he had been through the stock market crash, but the thing is that Bill Wilson was crashing all on his own. He didn't need the stock market to bring him down. He was a knee-crawling drunk, and his alcoholism had progressed to the point where the doctors and the family were seriously considering about putting him into an insane asylum. And that's what they did back in those days. You know, if you were incompetent, away you would go. And that was going to be his fate. But he had, I guess, what we call today the gift of desperation. He decided to try to stay sober, and to help him stay sober, he was trying to help other alcoholics. Well, the whole thing is a little crazy because, you know, he just got really strange about it, and he was running all over New York bringing home drunks, trying to sober him up and so forth, and he didn't have any luck at all. He was preaching to all these boozers, but at least one thing, he was staying sober by doing this, and he had been sober for about 6 months when he went out to Akron, Ohio on a little business trip. They were going to try to do a proxy fight with this little company out there. And when he was out there, he got real close to picking up a drink. So he reached out, and through a chain of phone calls, he ended up in the company of Dr. Bob Smith. Now, Bill knew that in order to stay sober, he had to try to work with another alcoholic, and that's how he got a hold of Dr. Bob. And Dr. Bob was another piece of work. He was a physician. Now, he's kind of funny because he was a proctologist. And, you know, a broken-down proctologist is kind of a funny situation. But he was really the town drunk. And, you know, a proctologist in those days, you know, if you had trouble with your exhaust pipe back in 1935, you know, they went up there with both hands. They didn't have any of that fancy, optical, what do you call it, fiber optics. They didn't have any of that stuff, you know. They had to really get in there and go to work. It's no wonder he drank so much. But, you know, when the two of them teamed together, they realized that there was a benefit, and they both felt it. Something happened when those two men got together, and they recognized it, and they thought, you know, we have something here. And they needed to find another drug now to try it out on. So they went to the hospital, and they got a hold of a guy named Bill D. Now, we know him today as Bill Dodson, and he's the guy who is memorialized in the painting The Man on the Bed. Now, they went in to see him, and they told him, you know, we're a couple of drunks. We used to be all screwed up just like you, Bill, but, you know, we're a lot better now, and why don't you join us, because we're going to have a society of alcoholics, and we're going to all help each other. And Dodson says, well, I don't know, I'll have to think about that. Well, so they said, well, we'll come back tomorrow, and they did, and Dodson, it is said, got up, put on his clothes, and walked out of the hospital with Bill and Bob, and never had another drink. Well, Smith never had another drink, and Wilson never had another drink, and these were three serious guys. You know, they were tough cases, but they found something. You know, and what they found together in this happenstance kind of crazy way was the essence of Alcoholics Anonymous, what we know today as Alcoholics Anonymous, the greatest support group in the world, a group that has helped millions of alcoholics find sobriety. And how does it work? Well, basically, it's the same today as it was then. You know, alcoholics have a sympathy for each other and an understanding of each other. And between alcoholics and among alcoholics, there is a feeling. There is something that runs down deep. It's inexplicable, really. I can't explain it fully, although I've been a part of it for many years. But I feel it. I feel it when I go to AA meetings. It is the power that helped me find sobriety. It's the power that's helped me stay sober. It's the power that comes to a group of us when we get together. I call it a higher power. I call it a power greater than myself, and it certainly is. In my case, you know, AA did for me what I could never have done for myself, because I could never stay sober. And that's at the heart of Alcoholics Anonymous. And you know, for outsiders, outsiders can be sympathetic. Outsiders can try to understand. Outsiders can even, you know, try to do everything possible to help an alcoholic. You know, but they can't quite get there. They will never be able to have that same feeling and that same identity. And it's not a surprise to me that other people, non-alcoholics, who come to AA, really don't like it. I mean, well, why would they? You know, why would a drug addict want to come to Alcoholics Anonymous? You know, they're just never going to get that identification and that feeling that happens constantly, regularly, between and among alcoholics. Well, that's my message today. Everybody take care, and thank you for listening.